Bernie Sanders. He'll most likely win today. I will congratulate him right now. A win is a win, so kudos to him. And it will be, he'll be adding to his winning streak. But in the Democratic primary, a winning streak is not what wins. It's delegates. So the math's the thing, as Hamlet might say, that is actually going to get you to the nomination. And right now, Hillary Clinton has the math in her favor. Look, even if Bernie Sanders won all of Wyoming's delegates today, it's 14 delegates at stake, her delegate lead would still be above 200. And it's going to be very difficult with the states that come after Wyoming, and Wyoming was tailor-made for Bernie Sanders. It's a majority white state. It's it's not densely populated, the least populated state in the United States. It's a caucus. It's in the West. The focus on progressivism has been pretty keen among Democrats. So again, tailor-made for Bernie Sanders. This was not a surprise. But moving forward, the demographics get very difficult for him, and the states that come after Wyoming, incredibly delegate-rich states that will help Hillary add to her map, which continues to be in her favor.
So, Nomi, it's true that even if he wins Wyoming, he still has a long way to go to catch up to Hillary Clinton in terms of delegate count. How confident is the Sanders camp that he'll be able to do that?
So there's this old political organizing phrase called the river. It is when the momentum is so large that you cannot stop it. And you can see that that's what's happening right now with Bernie Sanders' campaign. When he's won 8 of the 9 last primaries and caucuses in not just white, liberal, northeastern states, that's a problem for Hillary Clinton. And that's when you'll see those delegates start to turn. There's rules in the DNC that the pledged delegates have to reflect the voters' needs and wants. But guess what? Guess who decided to create those rules? Hillary Clinton, after 2008, she lobbied the DNC. You know, the issue here that the Hillary Clinton campaign is presenting, the only messaging that's coming out of their campaign and their hundreds of surrogates is the map. They're not talking about issues. They're not talking about what New Yorkers care about, because what we see on the Bernie Sanders campaign is everywhere from Buffalo, New York to the Bronx, issues of economic inequality, raising the minimum wage to $15 an hour, universal health care, fracking, all of these issues, not being so eager to go to war. You know, these are the issues that New Yorkers care about. And we saw this 2 years ago when Zephyr Teachout, a progressive that no one knew of, ran a very strong campaign against Andrew Cuomo, one of the strongest names in New York history. And she had no organization. She didn't have what Bernie Sanders has. So I think that Hillary Clinton might be shocked by the numbers that come in after the New York primary when she sees an organized movement that she can't stop.
And we'll have to wait and see what happens with the New York primary right around the corner. Maria, it was not too long ago that it seemed Hillary Clinton was ready to turn her attention to Donald Trump. Remember with that ad, what seemed she was really targeting Donald Trump. Why does it seem like this campaign is starting to take on a nastier tone?
Well, I think it's starting to take on a nastier tone because Bernie Sanders has gone back on his pledge to run a positive campaign, which is something that he promised to do back in April of last year. And clearly, as his campaign has realized that they cannot get there with the math, they're kind of, you know, they're kind of in desperation mode. I also Nomiki's right in terms of New York being focused on the issues. And that is exactly what Hillary Clinton has been talking about to New Yorkers. And as the two-term senator, she has a lot of support in New York. And frankly, one of the reasons I think that Bernie turned negative is because he was reeling from the disastrous, horrendous New York Daily News article editorial board that came out that essentially uncovered the lack of depth and knowledge on not just core issues that he campaigns on at every single campaign stop, but also foreign policy.
You said that was factually inaccurate?
It was fact-checked by the New York Times. What happened was everybody took two pieces of this interview by the New York Daily News before the editorial board and took it out of context. Nobody read the transcripts. It took 45 minutes.
I read the whole transcript.
Well, then you would understand how the banking process works. And the banking process is that it goes to legislate before Congress. And unfortunately, everyone took it out of context when he said it needs to go and be passed before Congress. And it's simple as that. But aside from the matter here, what we're seeing over the past week is every time something happens to Hillary Clinton, whether she has an outburst against an organizer, a Greenpeace organizer, or Bill Clinton belittles African Americans, what happens is they immediately go on the attack against Bernie Sanders. He has not run a negative ad. She's had super PACs run negative ads for the past 9 months. He only has a dozen surrogates that are unpaid. You know, Maria, you're ahead of a super PAC. There are hundreds of...
I'm not ahead of a super PAC.
Okay.
All right. I'm not ahead of a super PAC.
Well,
and by the way, hold on, Maria. We have to move on.
But listen, one thing we know is that the rhetoric is ratcheting up. It's speeding up. As we head into the New York primary, Maria Cardona.
It's just like 2008.
Thank you very
Hillary
much.
Hillary Sanders. All right. Hillary will continue to focus on the issues.
Okay. Oh, wait. A reminder, by the way, speaking of Hillary and Bernie, they're